The Sikorsky S-72 was more than just a visually striking aircraft. This unique and unusual vehicle could take off and land vertically like a chopper, but it could also fly fast and far like a plane. The S-72 would ultimately be neither a helicopter nor a plane. Instead, it was a new concept, an X-Wing, conceived through a joint effort between the U.S. Navy and NASA. Unfortunately, its innovative design ultimately proved too much for the time. The X-Wing was a concept designed to combine the vertical takeoff and hovering capabilities of a helicopter with the speed potential of a fixed-wing aircraft. It used a large four-bladed stiff rotor system that could be stopped mid-flight to turn into an X-shaped wing. In theory, the X-Wing was supposed to break away from the vertical takeoff and landing trend of early 1970s experimental aircraft, in which achieving a higher flight speed required extremely high rotor loadings, as still seen today in aircraft such as the V-22 Osprey. The X-Wing could instead achieve fixed-wing-only flight in the air by locking its rotor without the need for an additional wing. This meant a lower weight and more efficient design over other aircraft that needed both the rotor system and a separate wing. It also meant less powerful engines could be used. With its low hovering disc loading and the power to fly at high subsonic speeds, the X-Wing aircraft could both hover and fly a good portion of the flight envelope on only one of its two engines. This innovative concept was based on Professor Ian Cheeseman's work. Based at the University of Southampton, England, Dr. Cheeseman employed the Coanda effect to create and subsequently accentuate the lift on a cylindrical rotor blade. The Coanda principle states the tendency of a fluid jet to stay attached to a convex surface. When sufficient air is blown tangentially over a surface, the fluid will adhere and follow it until the curvature gets too big and detaches. If you've ever seen a ping pong ball spinning on a jet of air, that is the Coanda effect. The same principle has been utilized to create helicopter designs without tail rotors. Dr. Cheeseman believed that if designed to take advantage of the effect, the X-Wing's rotor could be powered up only for takeoff and landing, and then be locked in mid-flight to be used as a wing. To give the rotor blades the correct shape for vertical takeoff and landing, compressed air would be vented out of the edge's surface and controlled by a computer. In the early 1970s, U.S. Navy engineers at the David W. Taylor Naval Ship Research and Development Center decided to work on Professor Cheeseman's idea of lift control. They were joined by the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, and the development of a hybrid vehicle began. Known as the NASA Army Rotor Systems Research Aircraft, or the RSRA, the vehicle would be equipped with an advanced X-Wing rotor system. The researchers were reluctant to commit the system to a prototype or to a concrete helicopter production program. Ideally, the project would first fully explore the flight performance of the rotor. Before developing the program, novelty rotor configurations could only be tested either on a stationary whirl stand or in a full-scale wind tunnel, such as the one found in NASA's Langley Research Center. Because of these test limitations, there was a high risk associated with actually deploying the concept in flight. The first stages of the RSRA began as an investigation on how to increase the speed, overall performance, reliability, and safety of a rotor aircraft. The program also sought to reduce the noise, vibration, and maintenance cost of such aircraft. To achieve this, NASA and the Army concluded that a test aircraft dedicated to safely exploring all those boundaries would be worth developing. In the summer of 1971, NASA and the Army put out a request for proposal for a rotor test vehicle pre-design study. Sikorsky Aircraft and Bell Aircraft responded, and both were awarded 9-month study contracts. In July 1972, Sikorsky reported back to NASA and the Army with positive results on their pre-design study. They became the RSRA's primary developer. Since NASA wanted to keep program costs as cheap as possible, the use of existing aircraft and its components was highly encouraged. The end product included the Sikorsky S-67 helicopter base framework, paired with the Sikorsky's S-61 central rotor. The X-Wing was the most challenging concept Sikorsky aircraft ever worked on since it started operations in 1923. They named the aircraft the S-72. It would be a high-risk but high-payoff program. If technical challenges were overcome, and the full aircraft's correct achievement was achieved, Sikorsky would become a significant pioneer in state-of-the-art technology. Sikorsky established two different engineering teams. The first focused on developing the X-Wing rotor and wing systems, and how they would be applied to an aircraft. The second team concentrated on how to test these innovative and intricate systems on the RSRA. A lot of detailed work and collaboration was required from both teams. The aircraft's rotor blades needed to lift without centrifugal force or blade stiffening like other conventional helicopters. They would also have to be made from a stiff and durable double-ended material, since two of the blades would act as forward-swept wings in a stopped rotor flight mode. The Coanda effect was used to control the blade's lift. The engineers at Sikorsky replaced the mechanical swash plate used in conventional helicopters with a valving system in the pneumatic lines feeding continuous air to the rotor blades. The starting and stopping sequence of the X-Wing required complex high-frequency manipulation of the circulation control valving system. This required the most advanced computer technology at the time to manage the process. Other technical challenges were the inclusion of a large compressor to provide the circulation control air, as well as a high-energy clutch and a brake to start and stop the rotor mid-flight. The S-72 had a total length of 70.6 feet and a height of 14.5 feet. Its empty weight was 21,700 pounds, and the maximum takeoff weight allowed was 26,050 pounds. A low-set, straight monoplane wing with a wingspan of 62 feet was installed under the S-72, while the base model tail rotor was retained. The S-72 was powered by a pair of General Electric T-58 GE5 turboshaft engines with 1,400 horsepower each. The turbofan installations were two General Electric TF-34 GE400A engines with a 9,400-pound thrust, situated along the fuselage sides. Performance specifications had a maximum speed of 350 miles per hour listed, and a cruise speed of up to 260 miles per hour. The original S-72 test frame could be operated either with or without the rotor unit. Due to the risk of flying such an experimental design, an equally unique ejection system was developed for the helicopter to increase the test pilot's survivability. The process involved complete destruction of the main rotor blades by explosives. Rockets would then eject the three-man crew out of their positions and away from the fuselage. Only two of the aircraft were completed for training. The entire X-Wing system was built at Sikorsky's Florida facilities. The company's founder, Igor Sikorsky, had spent his early career years building fixed-wing aircraft, including the large flying boats that had become famous in the 1930s. But a new Sikorsky-designed fixed-wing plane had not flown in nearly half a century. Testing of the model began in December 1985 in a propulsion system testbed at Sikorsky. In 1986, the S-72 was transported to NASA's Dryden Flight Test Research Facility at Edwards Air Force Base in California in a Super Guppy KC-97 cargo aircraft. The entire flight test program was envisioned as a progressive accumulation of all the aircraft's features that needed testing. After several taxi tests, the S-72 was flown without the actual X-Wing blades. The blades were later reinstalled for a full system test. Other initial tests used dummy blades to examine the development of the experimental pneumodynamic system that shaped the blades with air from the compressor inlet to the blade root. Another notable completed test with the S-72 was the use of the central and tail rotor load measurement system to calculate the vertical drag of the airframe. With a focus on safety, the RSRA was designed to return to base in case of an emergency should the rotor blades be severed from the rotor head. This way it would fly like a fixed-wing airplane without the rotor. When this early test produced successful results, It was a day of celebration for the Sikorsky team. Initially, the plan was to next fly it with two rotor blades, then with four blades, all but the actual rotors stopped. By mid-1987, the S-72 advanced to where it flew with its complete rotor turning at full speed. And by the end of the year, Sikorsky scheduled a test in which the rotor would be stopped and started during mid-flight. Sadly, this never happened. In 1997, the U.S. government had funding issues and more critical priorities. The S-72's design was visually striking and innovative, but not exactly practical due to its complex systems needed to bring all of its new technologies together. The contract was eliminated. At the time of its termination, the government reviewed the program's costs and risks against the X-Wing concept potential. It was decided it would be in the best interest to terminate the program entirely. The program fell apart for the same reasons that shut down many other military and research programs. It was simply too expensive and technologically ambitious for its time. Although the Sikorsky S-72 flew several times, it always did so in either a full helicopter configuration or a full turbofan mode without the rotor blade. It never reached 350 miles per hour. Over the 5 years of the NASA Sikorsky contract, most of the aircraft's engineering team had resolved its many technical and physics challenges, such as the compressor and clutch development, software, composite material development, blade and rotor head fabrication. Several appropriate risk mitigation tests were accomplished in only a few short years. After the X-Wing program, Sikorsky gained extensive technical experience, which significantly advanced technologies for future aircraft. Simply put, at the time of the contract's termination, the X-Wing technology was still in its early development. The true potential of the concept could not be fully demonstrated.